then?
Was a birth as well, so we kept the placenta attached.
Yeah, okay, yeah. For a while, for how long?
Well, it just fell off for 3 days.
Oh, sick.
Yeah, it just fell off for three
days. You just keep them to get you to stay together for 3 days?
Yeah, I mean, I was just in the bed anyway.
Yeah, that's sick. When was this?
Yeah, so this was like nearly 3 months ago now. But yeah, I was sleeping and then she just came up to me, contraction started, and then she started giving birth. Which helped her through the process. Yeah, we bonded, man. We definitely bonded through that process. Yeah, all these five beautiful creatures came out one by one. It was about a 3.5 hour process, you know? But yeah, we chose not to neuter them for obvious reasons, man, just to allow them to enact their natural predisposition, which is to have their hormonal balance intact and to feel, not to disturb their perception of the world, you know? So, because of that, we get blessed with these beautiful creatures.
So I'm just gonna take Mo through some of my workout.
Yeah.
The outside edge.
On my outside edge.
Yeah, try and keep the toes lifted.
Yeah, that's it.
This is what I've programmed it all into this app. Yeah. So we just get to follow the app now. So sole roll, I just put 5 seconds because you're just meant to do it.
Yeah.
As long as it feels good in it, just as a warm up for the bottom of the feet, and then we move into this, everything else is timed. So we'll do this together and I'll tell you what we're doing.
Okay. Right.
Yeah. We've got a great.
So the toes, do you know like the telomeres?
Yes.
We'll get the foot down like you want to see, yeah. Focus on the big toe, and you can focus on the fourth toe as well, the fourth toe is the...
Wow, I've never had it engaged this much.
Are you feeling it?
Massive, bro. Yeah. It's burning.
Good. So that's just trying to connect the foot to the glute.
Yeah, sick. Yeah, that's sick. 30 seconds. Yeah. Alright,
so that is just kind of just kissing the floor, you're kind of like trying to lift off, yeah.
Hey. You're done in 3, 2, 1.
You just want to find a point where you can feel it shaking.
Mm-hmm.
You just find the shake. Kind of bouncing.
Yeah.
Change the angle of your knees. Just exploring and
just like, nice,
yeah, it's reflexive, me like.
Yeah.
I really think there's something to the reflexive bounce,
yeah.
Rather than like passively holding it.
Yeah.
It's just that like... So that was with like the ankle completely open, now the ankle's completely closed.
Okay, yeah.
And you're still working the knee joint, sure. You know what I mean? Because you want to work both. You're just kind of exploring the pigeon.
Yeah.
Drive at the foot. That's it. Rotate into it.
Yeah, rotate into it. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. 10 seconds
left till the end. Yeah, I do. You can do this.
And then I kind of like find.
You're done in 3, 2.
That's really nice now.
Yeah, you've got to explore.
I got that now. I wasn't in enough on the right side. The
rotation, yeah.
Yeah, I wasn't. We wash with the salt water.
Yeah, wash it off, man.
Whoosh. Go. Let me see Uncle Tim.
Hello. Show me
what's done.
Come back into the playroom.
Look at that, bro. Wild, mate. All this whole place was just blackberries. We had a lot of fun picking, man. He's just an absolute nutter. Which I like.
Yeah.
He's just straight, he's not trying to pretend to be anything, he's just, you see what you get.
Live by the sea, mate.
There you
go. This as well.
That's what I'm saying. On our way back, we'll head over to the other side of the forest. Yeah, good luck.
your new hangout spot.
This is it.
How long did it take you to find this when you moved here?
Not long. Not long at all. I came looking for it.
I can't believe this is Liverpool, man.
Man. Merseyside.
Merseyside. Yeah. Why did you move to Liverpool?
For nature.
What about...
Community here as well, right? Yeah, good, beautiful community. Brothers. Brotherhood.
Working on your relationship with God?
Always, man.
Yeah.
Always. God brought me here.
How long have you been on that path?
5-6 years, actively. Yeah, 5-6 years. As a seeker of truth.
Yeah.
And just building a relationship with the Most High.
Yeah.
Finding ways to pray and give thanks.
Do you love God?
I pray God loves me back.
Yeah.
You know.
I don't think there's a doubt about that, brother.
I pray, man.
There's no doubt about that.
It's God whether, keep us humble.
It's whether we're able to receive that love. That's on us, isn't it?
Yeah. That's right.
Yeah.
I wouldn't be here if he didn't love me.
We wouldn't, would we? None of us.
Yeah. Everything outside of receiving from the divine is will never fulfill you, will never be whole. So yeah, stop looking for divine love in the wrong places, man. In stuff. It's not in stuff. It's called Tawbah.
What's Tawbah?
Tawbah. Tawbah is repentance.
Yeah.
It's like you just define it very well. If you feel remorse for a sinful deed and you're sincere about that and you make repentance, then that gets wiped out.
Yeah.
And you have to have faith in that the loving mercy of the Most High in that through that act.
And there's a very real spiritual law.
Very real spiritual law. Yeah.
Yeah, I agree.
Tawbah.
Yeah. Tawbah.
Tawbah. Yeah, it's the Arabic for it.
Oh, cool.
That's at the root of spiritual practice, man.
Yeah. And for me to sin,
yeah,
the way I define it, or I've learnt the definition from divine truth, and that makes the most sense to me, is simply to miss the mark of love. And I think often when people hear the word sin, they just put it into a religious context and it's some like judging, punishing God. But it's simply to miss the mark of love. And when that happens, repentance is simply feeling remorse for doing that. So it's like if you react in an angry way at someone, you know, unlovingly, and then afterwards you're like, I kind of wish I was a bit mean that I reacted that way. You feel remorse for it. That is simply part of repentance. So it's, I think, getting over the language.
Yeah, that's the issue. The issue is always in the language.
I agree, yeah.
The ability to articulate these divine spiritual laws.
Spiritual laws, which are very real, yeah.
Yeah, you can't define them in... I mean, you need... Certain languages can... higher languages which don't really exist anymore.
Yeah.
But that's why the older kind of languages, the Semitic languages, the Hebrews, the Aramaics, and obviously in Arabic, they are so high level, intellectual and complete in their ability to articulate in human form. That's why studying them can bring you closer to the divine, because it's high intelligence.
Mm.
But not just it, this type of intelligence, this type of intelligence. Do you know what I mean?
Soul intelligence.
Soul intelligence. Yeah.
So we're just talking about the fact I don't label myself as religious, necessarily as like Christian or anything. But,
yeah.
But you asked me what I follow, and I say that I call it the narrow path, what Jesus called it, the narrow path. And you say you say the narrow path in your prayer as well.
Yeah, yeah. So through which we believe... is divine revelation in the Quran. We have the initial prayer, the first prayer which we recite all the time, and it's Ihdina Sirat al-Mustaqim. We're constantly asking the Most High to guide us on to this straight, narrow path. Constantly, 20-30 times a day.
Wow.
You know, Ihdina Sirat. So even though I say I'm Muslim, like, I cannot claim to be anything. I just try to follow guidance and ask God to continue guiding me.
Yeah, that's beautiful. You know, yeah,
I do that all the time.
I can dig that. I can dig that for sure.
Very interesting how you say you're not Christian, but
yeah,
you know, you certainly believe in Isa, or Yeshua.
Yeah, I believe in what he taught.
In what he taught, yeah. Assalamu alaikum.
Hello.
Around the back. It's up there. There you go. It's for you. There you go. Yeah.
Who's this?
This is Yahya. So Yahya is the biblical John the Baptist.
Cool.
Yeah. In Arabic it means like life-giving, life force.
Okay.
Yeah. Living. It's 5 weeks, 6 weeks.
6 weeks.
Yeah, yeah. 6 weeks.
How's fatherhood? Your first time, yeah?
Yeah. My first human child. I've had a few feline ones. No, it's a blessing, man. Isn't it? Yeah. It's a blessing. It's a gift.
Yeah. Can you imagine?
Try my best to honour it. Big needles, small needles, perfect.
Ooh. Yeah. That was a good reaction, wasn't it?
Yep.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
That one there.
Yeah. I wonder what just putting the big one on there would do.
Let's do it.
Just literally putting it on there.
Big boy.
Thank you, Lord, for this beautiful food. Thank you, Habiba.
Thank you.
Soft bone that is.
Like, there, I've always got energy in Ramadan, but this.
You can, like, clip it on the up as well.
Yeah.
It's just like, it just sends the vibration, like, into. You can't not squeeze your glutes.
Yeah, yeah.
Because it's pulling you directly against your hips.
Yeah, yeah.
So you're here in this child's position, but
yeah.
You could do it here.
You can, yeah.
But then you're adding a whole extra joint, so we may as well take the ankles out.
Yes.
It allows us to isolate more.
I'm with you.
And then you can fold and then. And it's the thrusting, man. It's in.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's the creation of life. Like,
yeah, it is.
And hinging is running, hinging is walking.
Yeah.
Squatting is jumping, hinging is walking, right? Thrusting is walking, running, thrusting the creation of life. It's the up dog, down dog in yoga.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? There's a reason that's all.
So yeah.
Give that one maybe. You feel your glutes?
Obviously.
Yeah.
Yeah, solid.
You can't not, can you?
Yeah, solid.
So you go here, knees slightly bent.
Yeah.
And then you're trying to, this is the flowability stuff, where you're trying to like, stretch that upper hamstring as much as possible.
Yes.
So you're trying to put your sit bones as high as you can, or your coccyx as high as you can.
Yeah.
With the knee slightly bent, and that just, your whole fascia's engaged there.
Yeah.
And you can just hang out here for like a minute.
Sure.
Or you can do the thrust again. And that, you just feel your whole back chain, your posterior chain is just like driving you forwards. Because that.
Lift your ankles as well. Yeah. I'm saying, are you doing that?
You can do that.
Yeah.
You can explore it all. You can go one side.
Yeah.
And just hit like that, you know, rotate in.
Rotating, yeah.
Rotate in here.
Yeah.
Slight bend, because otherwise we're disconnecting if we're bent. If we're,
so
you don't sprint with locked knees, you know what I mean?
No.
So it's that turns the fascia on.
Yeah.
Up, and then.
Yeah, beautiful.
Driving through. And that, because you're in a dynamic angle, when you're running.
Yeah.
Well, like, I'm leaning like this.
Yeah.
If I'm just standing in the gym deadlifting,
No.
That's not carrying, you're not, the fascia's not switched on.
Yeah.
You need a three-dimensional angle for the fascia to wake up.
Yeah.
It's just muscle otherwise. That's where I'm seeing it, you know.
So this is movement in context, in action. Yeah, it's a motivation to get up and hustle when you can just sit here and cuddle up with all of these lot, you know.
Yeah.
Congratulations again. Thank you. Bye-bye. See you when you're a bit bigger. Come on then. Come on then. Let's go. Peace, brother. Yeah. Peace, brother. Stay blessed, man.
Have a safe journey back.
Yeah, thanks. You too. Take care of the family.
Yeah, always, man. Bye-bye. Keep us in your prayers.
Yeah, man.
And let's get this program on the go, man.
Yeah.
Trust me.
I'll get it to you tomorrow, man, and some links and that. And yeah, we'll get it out to the world.
Amazing.
Love, fam.
Yo, stay blessed, man.
You too, brother. Peace, man. Oh, what a day. What a day.